What is up, Facebook? I am Jay. I'm sitting here in my studio with my lovely wife, Chelsea.
Hello.
Who's going to act as camera woman and keeping an eye on the baby monitor because our boys are upstairs in their big boy bed being a little crazy. And our daughter, Summer, insisted on playing with her iPad. So bedtime's kind of crazy right now, but I'm going to do some painting for you right now. Here's my blank canvas, and I literally have no clue what I'm going to paint, which makes things more interesting. So, also, Chelsea's reminding me. Throw any questions at me that you'd like. She'll, as long as our babies upstairs cooperate, she will recite some questions, and I will try to answer as we go. So, let's do this. So, the paint I'm going to use tonight is acrylic, which is pretty much what I use for my live paintings because it dries really quickly, which is really nice for these kinds of things. Usually I use oils if I'm not in a rush, but we are in a rush, so. Since when you don't know where to start, when you have artist block, you literally just take a wet paintbrush and just see where it goes. And this is not a magic wand. This is actually for painting. This keeps your hands still. Let's see here. Kind of feeling something over here-ish. There we go. All done. Let's see where this takes me. So this is pretty much what I do when I'm on stage painting. Just grab a brush and go at it and move my hand around and kind of like look to see what the canvas is telling me to do. Currently it's telling me don't look stupid in front of a lot of people, which I'm trying not to do, but I always have a paper towel in my hand because I like to make a mess. So let's see. I'm picturing where I want the sun to be. Picturing sun somewhere in this direction, so it means I can make everything else a little bit darker.
Can you just tell people if they're asking questions in different languages to try to translate it?
Oh, yeah. Well, you can tell them that. You guys, if I know a lot of you are from other countries, and you probably have no idea what I'm saying. Although you probably speak better English than most Americans, which is kind of cool. But if you're going to ask questions, I am one of those Americans that don't know a lot of languages. I know a little Spanish.
Well, your wife is, from yeah. Definitely.
Well, Chelsea especially. I actually know a little bit of Spanish, and I've been trying to teach myself some French. But if you have other questions, try to go on Google Translate and figure out how to write it in a way where Chelsea can understand what you're saying. But totally appreciate you joining me. That's really, really cool. Seem to be cooperating at the moment, at least. If you see the camera drop, that means our toddlers probably jumped out of their bed and they're in their closet at the moment. So far, so good.
Watching from Australia. Don't worry, we don't speak any better English than American.
Right on, mate. But you guys sound cooler speaking our language, so... For those of you watching, sorry, it's a kind of a slow process, especially at the beginning, so I like have no idea what this is going to be yet, which is kind of fun. I sort of like that, but gets really messy at first, and then I kind of clean it up as I go, as things start appearing to me. Chelsea loves blues and teals, so she won the vote right before we hit go live. She said, you know my favorite colors, so we're at least starting out now with this, but who knows, it might turn into like a purple and yellow painting for all I know. We will see. So, Right now I'm just trying to establish like where the darks might be, where the highlights might later go, what's trying to figure out what pieces I want to keep loose and which ones I want to kind of tighten up a little bit.
Hello from Argentina.
Hola.
I said genio. I don't know what that means.
Genio.
With a G?
No, it's one of those words I don't really know that well.
We're learning.
Yeah. I probably know more like Puerto Rican slangs and stuff.
Everyone's talking in Spanish. I think they're messing with me.
Oh, guys, you're screwing with me. I'm gonna Google Translate this tomorrow, whatever you guys are saying, and if you're really messing with me, you're in big trouble.
Oh, what is it that you're spraying?
Oh, this is a special formula of tap water. And this is just to keep the paint wet, since acrylic is water-based. Everyone always thinks there's like a magic formula in here, but yeah, it's literally just water, because acrylic dries when water evaporates. That's what makes it dry, so if I keep it moist and keep the water content in there, then it'll stay long wet a lot longer. They make all sorts of like fancy palette stay wet formulas and whatnot, but especially for stuff that's like this quick, I don't really mess with that. I just spray it with water.
DJ stopped by to say he loves my laugh.
DJ! I love your jawline, dude. Perfect 10, DJ and Nikki. 10 Ho of Realty, give a shout out.
Hello from Israel. How's your Hebrew?
Shalom! I had a bar mitzvah. But my Hebrew is really horrible.
Aw. Hey, Chelsea and Jay are watching from Point Pleasant before kids' bedtime. Heidi, age 8, says you're good at painting.
What's up?
Getting so many countries.
Yeah, everyone give a shout out where you're from. I don't want to have to click and find out later.
Yeah, we have Brazil.
Brazil.
We had a Mexico. He's the one that's messing with me in Spanish.
Oh, man. That's okay. I could take it.
Bar mitzvah? Seriously, are you Jewish?
I was raised Jewish. I'm kind of a agnostic right now.
Belmar.
What's up, Belmar? Alright, once things start feeling like I need another color, like they do now. Alright, so, what color to get next? All kinds of choices. I think I want to throw in some yellowish. Just because.
Hi, Jeff!
Which Jeff are we saying hi to?
Cooperstein. Birth client.
Ah, what's up, birth client? Chelsea is a birth doula, for everyone who does not know, so she just had one of her little baby helper clients pop up here.
Guys, let us know if you have any questions. We have lots of shout-outs. We have West Long Branch, Spring Lake. We love your 311 print.
Oh, thank you, guys. Love my local peeps. You guys can, like, vote on colors, too, if you're like, oh, do blah, blah, blah. Like, throw in plaid or something. Nah, don't do that. Take that back. What is everyone doing this evening? How about telling us some stuff, you guys? This is where I get my paint all messy and I squirt it into the camera. Come on, paint. This is like one of these things when I'm on stage, I don't want anyone to see that I'm trying to forcefully squeeze paint out of my tube. But it's all good. find another kind of blue. Let's see here. What do we have? This looks nice. This is Payne's Gray, one of my favorite colors.
Payne's Gray, like P-A-I-N.
Are you asking me or someone else?
No, I.
Payne's Gray. This is Atelier.
Oh, the brand.
This is important. This is Interactive Artist Acrylic Atelier. It's made by Chroma. Hmm. It's a lot of information to swallow, but these are really good people that get me these paints, and they're super cool because you can keep them wet for pretty much forever as long as you keep them wet, and then even after they dry, you can still go back and moisten them and make them workable, which is pretty cool.
Hence the spray.
Hence the spray. That works with any kind of acrylic for that matter, but this particular brand stays wet a lot longer. No jokes. Oh.
Children watching.
Yes, perhaps.
Daddy?
Yes?
Daddy,
speaking of children. I'm painting a picture of a wave.
Oh.
Want to say hi to everyone?
Hi.
To all of you that support me by buying prints, there you go. It's my telethon moment.
Right,
buy art.
We have questions. When did it hit you that you wanted to pursue a living as a painter? What were your first steps towards where you are now?
That's a cool question. I have been wanting to be and pursuing art since I was pretty much my daughter's age. I've always been interested in art, probably for a lot of reasons, but I also kind of sucked at a lot of other things, so really helped me kind of figure out everything, and so I always loved it, and I just recently, maybe a year or two ago, found a book report that I wrote in like grade school that kind of described pretty much what I'm doing now, almost to a T, which is kind of cool to find. I found it in the attic when we moved, right, Chels? Like,
yeah.
And so that kind of just solidified the fact that I kind of always have wanted to do this. And what was the second part of the question? Like, what steps did I take?
Oh boy.
Is that anything?
Yeah. So, what were your first steps towards where you are now?
So that's really hard because I don't know about the first steps, but I would say that some of the first steps was like just sharing what I do all the time, like showing everyone what I do, and then another big one was like kind of embracing the hustler, the business side of myself, I guess. That's a really important thing that I neglect sometimes to say is that to be a good working artist, you have to really know how to be a good business person. And the first memory I have of doing that is in kindergarten, actually. I sold these little pieces of paper that had tattoos on them, and you'd like go like this and wet your arm and then stick the tattoo on there. And I got the idea from a Cracker Jack box that I sold the idea, and I would sell kids in my kindergarten class for like 10 cents these little tattoos. And I have stories kind of all like that growing up. Like in various forms, I used to paint like people's jackets, like jean jackets, in like grade school or high school, and then all sorts of different versions of being an artist. But I've always done a version of being an artist, and if whoever asked that is looking to be an artist, I think you always have to kind of put yourself out there and try any form of what you're doing that feels good, and the money will kind of come to you. Hope that answers your question a little bit.
There's a lot piling up. How about some birds? Peter and Point Pleasant's requesting. Nikki would like a sunset, and Elle would like some purple.
Oh, okay. Elle would like that?
Yes.
Fair enough.
And then, what are your favorite brands of paint?
My favorite brands of paint. This is where I give the unpaid sponsorship. my favorite brand of oil paint, in case they're watching and they want to throw me lots of paint, is Gamblin oil paint. It's one of my favorites. I have a few favorites, but all these are pretty much filled up with, like...
Oh my god, that's so gross.
Yeah, it's really nasty. It's really impossible to keep oil paint clean. They're actually organized by color and tone and shade, but you wouldn't tell from the mess. But then with acrylics, the ones I'm using now are some of my favorites as well. The Chroma brands, they have all kinds of different versions of their paint, and I kind of use them all. And then, where is it? Somewhere around here is Pedleo, really nice people that gave me some paint as well. But I'm kind of open to using really anything. But the ones that I mentioned are some of the ones I use most. So I know they work.
Wait, let me go back. Your style is so recognizable. What advice would you give to young artists about finding their own personal and unique style?
Don't be afraid to do something, to do work that you think is horrible. I think a lot of people try to like find their style because they think that's what they're supposed to do. They think they're supposed to go out and like emulate every other artist. And if they copy enough artists, all of a sudden it'll look like theirs. But if you copy everyone, it's a great way to learn technique, but it's just going to like emulate everyone else. I think for me, one of the first times I realized I even had a painting style was, Chelsea, remember this story with that guy Dave that scanned my paintings.
Yeah.
I dropped a painting off. It was one of my first like surf-related paintings, and he told me, this is like very, I think he said something like, this is like very Alders-esque or something like that. And I was like, what? What does that even mean? Like, I had all these insecurities about my painting at that point. I still do. You always do, right? And I remember thinking like, what does that mean, first of all? And like, then I started pondering it and I talked to Chelsea afterwards and I was like, but yeah, but this is wrong with my painting and that's weird and this is bizarre and blah, blah. And I started to like take a step back and realize that all the things that I thought were flaws were actually my style. And I think musically you can kind of explain that concept, because some of my favorite types of music are like acoustic tracks that are like not produced. And what's cool about those is that you hear the flaws. And I think art is really great like that, because if there's flaws in it, if you might think they're flaws, someone else might think it's beautiful. So I think a lot of the warped, weird, strange things we think about our work is actually what's cool about it. And if you would just embrace the difference in it and stop trying to compare yourself to everyone else, then I think the style kind of just comes through without you looking for it. I think that advice could be used like in a lot of areas of life, like dating or like finding out where, oh, there goes splatters on the floor. Well, happy little accident. It's not paint splatter, it's bird poop. Yeah, it's a good topic that everyone likes to explore that I know. It's important to think about, because no one really knows. I think, you know, you could say your style finds you, but I think it just comes through you when you let it, when you kind of like remove the tension and pressure and stress about finding your style. Like, it's like the holy grail. It's your style is always going to change. My style is always changing. You find a style and then you find another style, and then another style finds you, and then you go back and forth.
That was Ashley Golick. Okay. Thanks, Ashley.
Thank you, Ashley.
And we have from Michael Weidinger.
Michael, what's up, Mike?
Love the live painting. Is there any music you find that helps drive your creativity?
Yeah, actually, currently, you probably can't hear it because it's really low, because I didn't want to drown.
No, you're getting compliments on the music.
Oh, okay. I'm listening to the thing, like a Miles Davis. Miles Davis iTunes radio station. I listen to a lot of jazz and classical, and then I listen to, then I find myself painting and taking myself too seriously. I start like feeling, oh boy, I'm getting way too serious, and then I like usually switch it up and put Jay-Z on, or like some old school 90s rap, and then I find myself getting a little bit too wacky, and then I kind of tone it down, and sometimes I'll put on like an audiobook, and I'll just listen to just an audiobook, and then sometimes I'll just put on ambient noise. Like if I'm painting an ocean, sometimes I'll listen to like ocean sounds, and then sometimes I'll listen to like binaural beats. If you guys know what that is, you can look it up. I just kind of play it by my mood, whatever I feel like I need. Like if I feel like I'm being too serious, I'll make something, put something on that's less serious, and vice versa. And I think if you just listen to your body and your mind and listen to what your creativity wants to hear, I think your creativity kind of speaks through you, and if you listen to it, it'll kind of tell you like, dude, change the station, this sucks. And you're like, okay, I'm sorry. And, yeah, the less you consciously think about it, the more your inner voice will kind of speak through you.
Will you be at Donovan's show on Friday?
Yes, yes, totally. I'm really excited to see Matt.
That's
Donovan.
The Ten Hoves. Tell them to get there.
Ten Hoves, you better be there.
Get a sitter.
Yes, we'll be there. I'll give a less answered response since it's you guys.
Ashley said thank you. Excellent advice.
Awesome.
And I have a
lot of paper towels.
Yeah, we go through a lot of people in this house in general. do you prefer oil or acrylics? Why there?
So, if I had to answer that with one quick answer,
I'd
say...
That's Kate Catanella, by the way. Hi, Kate.
Who is it?
Kate Catanella.
Oh, hey, what's up? if I had to answer that really quickly, I would say oils, but it depends on what I'm doing. Like, if I was doing this in oils, I would definitely not prefer oils, because you'd be like, wow, this is the most slow, boring process on the planet Earth, which it already probably feels like to some of you, sorry. But if I have my time, and time is not limited, then I prefer oils, but... It's definitely a cooler experience for me to paint it in oils, but I like this too.
Cool. And let's see, what do you like most about waves, and what is it? Sorry, just translate it. And what is it that the waves represent for you?
What I like about waves, well, painting waves or like waves in general. So that's a tough one, but I would say, let's see, a good answer to that. In general, I guess we're talking about painting since I'm painting, so I'll answer it that way. Painting waves is amazing because water in general has a lot of different forms, right? You have ice and mist and rain and steam and all kinds of cool things water does, but it also has all kinds of important qualities. So it could be transparent, it could be opaque, it could be shiny, it could be more matte. It could take on forms that are more abstract. So for me, I like some modern art, and I like some elements of stylized abstract art. So for me, it kind of get my jollies out of doing some more abstract elements and shapes and forms. And it kind of feels like the wave or the water or nature or whatever form I'm creating kind of is speaking through me. And as I'm painting it, I kind of envision how it's moving and how it feels and what colors are kind of bouncing off and how and why. And like, if I create this light being yellow, I have to think, like, how it's affecting everything else. Like, will it come through as transparent? Will it bounce off? Will that reflection cause another reflection up here? So I like kind of the relationship of it all, like, the narrative of figuring it all out, and, like, the power and the beauty of it, and the different moods that it can set. I love, you know, being out in the water surfing. A lot of times, for my, you know, fellow surfers out there, like, you know that a lot of times you surf, and most of the time on an average day, you're just sitting in the water talking to your friends most of the time, and then every so often you're lucky enough to catch one, at least in Jersey. So I like just being able to be in the water and connect with the ocean and see how the animals and the birds interact with the water and the air and the mist. And so I don't know if that's a long-winded answer, but that's kind of how I feel about it. So.
All right, let's switch topics. So tell us a bit about the 311 print process. Is there an original print? Was it screen printing? Was it layers? Was it computer? Where did it
go? All right. I assume a fellow graphic designer?
I don't know. This is for Ian Silver.
Ian. So Ian, that process artistically happened. I'm trying to think if I still have a sketch laying around. Somewhere I do. It started out as a series of sketches, different concepts that I had, and... sent it over to my buds at 311, and we kind of narrowed down to an idea. And then I took that idea from the sketch and worked it up in Photoshop with a drawing tablet. So there is no original painting, per se. And I did that similar process to when I'm painting with traditional paints, in layers upon layers upon layers. I don't really rely much on computery stuff like filters too much. I do sometimes, but... and then I just worked it up in Photoshop with the pressure-sensitive tablet and the drawing tablet, and then it was screen-printed, not by myself. A lady named Roberta in California printed it, which came out really, really nice. I hope that answers your question, Ian.
So, Jay Trev, hi.
What's up, dude?
Hey, brother, can you tell the people a little bit about the album covers your work is graced upon? Or he said, or which musicians are featured in some of your paintings?
Yeah, that's a long answer, so I'll just pick parts of that to answer. So the first album cover I did was In the Ocean by Echo Movement, and if any of those guys are watching at some point, guilt trip! I need a reunion tour, Dave and Steve and Colin... So Echo Movement was an amazing band that I'm so pissed off broke up. They're amazing, really, really close friends of ours, and that was the first album cover that I did. And I don't know, like, chronologically, but Peter Dixon is a musician in Australia did his cover, and I did another one for Echo Movement, and then our friend Mishka asked me to use one of my paintings on his album, and that was super cool.
And then who's featured in paintings?
And then who's famous? Well, he knows the answers to all these. Yes, he's just getting me to talk, so yeah. That's cool. I appreciate that. A lot. I've actually painted a bunch of musicians, but I think that probably started out at least with Donovan and G-Love and Matt Costa and ALO from a tour that I was on in Brazil in 2007. You can go on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/JAlders. It's a cheap plug there. And you can look up that tour and see how that all came about. That was a super amazing experience. And I did a piece of Citizen Cope that he commissioned me for. And painted some other musicians. I did one piece that was kind of loosely inspired by my friend Quincy Mumford. And I'm sure I'm forgetting a bunch, but that's a good start for that.
David across the street says, can you paint an Escher-esque impossible wave?
I can, just not within an hour. I would love to do that. I actually have a bunch of stuff like that in my sketchbook, but in this limited time that I'm here, that's not going to happen.
Lots of comments, but if anyone else has more questions, send them our way.
Messy paint.
Do you do any custom paintings? I assume that's translated. I don't know. I mean, I guess.
I do custom paintings. I mean, my commission stuff that I do is considered custom, and I'm actually working on a. Come on, paint, get out of here. I'm working on a commission.
Oh, it's my color.
Yeah, Chelsea loves this color. or variations of this color, at least. So, yeah, I'm working on a commission painting right now for a really cool guy in Texas that I can't tell you guys about yet, which is going to be a really big deviation off of what you guys are used to seeing from me as far as, like, subject matter goes, but it's going to be really cool. And I don't do a huge amount of commission stuff, but I definitely do, and it keeps me really busy, like the 311 stuff or the slightly stupid stuff that I've been blessed enough to do and all the different bands I work with. That's all like commissioned custom stuff.
Jay Chow said, haha, I thought it'd be cool for people to hear, and I like to participate.
I like your participation.
The Ten Hoes from L. Jay, I'm seeking art classes in the fall. I'm going to paint something for you. What would you like?
Oh, man. Ooh. I want you, L, to draw or paint something that is not copied from your light box.
Oh.
I want you to paint something that means something to you, that's not copied, and I want you to show me whether you think it's bad or good or not.
Sounds good. This is for Laurel. I find myself alternating between the creative outlets of photography, painting, playing guitar, and dance. In what other ways do you express your creativity? By the way, this painting is looking gorgeous.
Ah, thank you. I assume this is Laurel in Asbury that was shooting photos, perhaps, because that's the only Laurel I know, but if it's not, sorry. But what other, so I think it's important to nurture creativity in whatever form it comes to you, and I'm kind of notorious at that. I kind of often wish I was just one of those people that only did one thing, so I would probably be a lot more successful and a lot better at painting if I only painted, but I really, really love to play guitar when time allows for it or when I make time for it, and I really love yoga, and I love rock climbing, and I've been trying to teach myself how to play piano, and I love to write a lot. I'm actually working on a book, which is taking me entirely too long, but I feel like it's worth it. So I love to do writing, and I think creativity goes in everything, like even business activities, there's tons of creativity in. Parenting, there's tons of creativity in. And I feel like just not labeling it is important, because if you label it, then you get pressure on yourself, so I think it's more important to play and like see where you're being pulled. So like in your, you know, instance, like whether it's art or for, you know, photography of any sort, don't pressure yourself. Just see if you're in the mood to do photography, do photography. And if you're in the mood to cook, cook. Because they all kind of play off of each other a lot. I hope that answers your question a bit. Let's switch out smaller brush times. The brushes, once you start getting into it, the big brushes get too clunky. They're really, really fun at the beginning, but then you start getting, it might be too small, but let's see. So right now, if there's any artists watching, I'm trying to just kind of figure out what the light is going to do and kind of where the reflections might happen, and then chances are I'll probably paint right over them anyway, but it kind of gives me a good starting point. And this is like why my paintings take forever. If I'm doing like an oil painting, it's like I'll paint it and then paint over it and then paint over it and then look, take a step back and think it's great, and then the next day I'll hate it. And Chelsea always laughs at me about that process. But when I'm doing these quick ones, then I'll have the luxury of kind of taking too many steps back. I kind of have to just commit to it and say, you know what, I'm only going to paint for an hour. If it's terrible, that's all good. I learned something from it. I had some cool, weird conversations with people I can't see, and, and so it's all good, you know?
We have the Georgian Court. A shout out to the Georgian Court University Art Department.
Oh, Georgian Court. What's up, local peeps?
Rick Alexander says, looking good.
Rick, what's up, dude? You know, Rick, that Chelsea's learning how to garden because of your Facebook group. You should give a shout out to what that group's called.
So I don't remember right now.
Oh, man. Rick, put it in like the comments. People can follow us. We actually have cucumbers thanks to you. Rick is also an amazing handyman that's built two bathrooms and built the studio, actually, they were standing in, and built my bouldering wall in my garage. Mm-hmm. Richard Alexander. You guys can click on his link. How's that for the shout out, bro?
The Gomez's are here.
Gomez's! Oh man, you suck for not living here. I would love to have Gabe playing music right now. That would be so sick. But no, I want to live in Orlando instead, where I can't see Jay ever. This is weird because I like usually paint alone, and I'm like noticing all my weird like positions that I do, like all these different balancing,
or creeping
ballet weird things that I'm doing right now.
What about your artist stick?
My artist stick. You know what? The artist stick is for when I'm painting more carefully, and I can't paint. I don't have that luxury of painting carefully right now. I kind of just have to go balls to the wall and get sloppy with it and be okay with it. Now let's see, I have to find some mist.
So much for an amazing 311 print in New Jersey. Welcome to the 311.
Ah, thank you guys. You and your fellow 311 people, 311 heads, is there a name for it? But you guys are amazing. Had such a warm like welcoming to that band, and our friend Dave Bain is like a ginormo 311 fan, so I was especially happy to be able to show him that piece. He was so stoked. So Dave, if you're watching, shout out. Shout out also to Peter Raspler, one of the managers of the band, who's like been a really great friend, pen pal kind of guy. I've known him for like 10 years, and it's been a really cool experience having it all unfold.
What other medium do you have you worked in?
What other mediums have I not worked in?
Have you worked in?
I know, I'm kind of just being...
Oh. Just sorry.
I've worked in everything. So, like, literally, I shouldn't say literally. I have not worked in everything. I've worked in sculpture, different kinds of sculpture. I was, like, super into photography, like, from college up till, like, 10 years ago or so. And really, really was into photography, graphic design a lot. And... one of my first gigs was, I was in high school, I got a gig doing little figurine sculptures that became produced, thanks to my dad. He got me the job doing that. And I also did caricatures, A Great Adventure, which was kind of like a weird little twist on things. But what other mediums? Let's see.
Yeah, for the record, somewhere in New Jersey exist tiny little porcelain sculptures of penguins that Jay did for... a collecting company, so
yes.
You own one.
There you go.
Hi, Hi, Mrs. Larson.
Hi, Cam. Kim said she's gonna hang out with us this summer, but
I saw it.
Oh, you saw it.
Summer.
Messing my guilt trip up, Kim.
Summer. Say hi, Mrs. Larson. Anyone new coming in, you're welcome to ask any questions you want.
Yeah, we're just having like a painting jam session here. You guys are stuck listening to all my weird answers to everything. Let's see. Mix some of this up. How do I see this going? Let's see. How about right here? Boom, 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 boom. This is like usually when I would switch up the music to something else, I think. But I'll listen to Miles a little more.
Sorry, I'm gonna get in there.
No, it's all good. You do that. I'm gonna go switch the music up a little bit.
Jay Trot says we should show Summer's family portrait. It's all the way upstairs, or I would.
This is such a good song. Who was asking the music? Was that Jeremy?
No.
Or someone else?
Yeah.
We listen to everything around here. We're listening to Taylor Swift as my kids were dancing around upstairs, which is, that's all Chelsea, that's not me, so. And then listen to a lot of reggae and a lot of acoustic jammy music. All like the musicians that I've toured with, I like love all their music. I'm actually sitting on an official G-Love chair. You guys check that out. My boy G-Love gave me that chair, which I'm really proud to have as my studio furniture. Sometimes I listen to his music and I tap my foot and pretend I know what I'm doing with like a harmonica and I don't, but. So. Jay-Z, if you're listening, I'd love to work with you sometime.
Me too. Just framed your 311 poster and hung it the other day. Great work.
Ah, sick. You better send me a photo. I want to see it. I've seen some cool custom frames people have been tagging me in, which is pretty rad. Also, for anyone watching, make sure you're on my newsletter. I've been trying to be more active about putting cool stuff up there. A lot of pressure I'm throwing on myself to sound cool, so in those newsletters, I'm trying to include some little morsels of goodness.
Gabe asked Brady if he would like to ask you a question. He said, yes, Jay, I love your paintings.
Aw, Brady, I love you, dude. So, I think I need a little more of that yellow. It's kind of funky. I don't know what you guys see. It's the same thing that I see, because I like kind of see it like 10 steps ahead and then go off in these weird tangents, and some people might be like, what are you doing? You're messing it up.
Hi, Brady.
What's up, Brady? Brady man. Brady Gomez in the house.
bars. This is looking good. I love your work. Just so you know, you gave me inspiration. I would like to meet you guys one day.
Oh, that's rad. Where do you live?
Kevin, where do you live? Well, so I have a question. This paint says mural paint.
Yeah.
So is that meant for big mediums, like, or bigger? Like...
Yeah, that's it's more a little bit more fluid, so it'll flow a lot better. The paint I'm using now is like super thick and sticky paint. This is kind of like closer to an oil paint, which is kind of fun sometimes to get this like really thick, sticky paint. But when you're doing a mural, that paint over there is really great because it's more watery. It's like thinner and flows better and has more coverage. Okay, Eminem's playing. Now it's getting real, yo.
Friendly language.
Yes. Yeah, if there's any like bad language on the music, sorry guys, but
it's inspiring.
I'm a flip-flop wearing gangsta rap lover. I really needed to hear this song. This is like so amazing.
By the way, Elle, there's some purple in there.
Yes. Did she request purple? I forgot about that. Oh, sorry. Okay, I'm going to put more in there purposely for her.
It's in there. Sorry, I'm tired.
There is purple in there. The doctor told you to go see.
Popping up for a flop.
Sorry for the language, guys. Earmuffs. I didn't want to talk. They got something to say. So, this is kind of where I'm like trying to find like the patterns. If any of you guys are like surfers or just love looking at the ocean, I'm kind of like looking at the painting as though it was actually water. I'm trying to like predict and imagine where things would happen. Like if I was sitting on the water, where would I see highlights and where would the shadows be moving and in what direction and how can I paint them in a way where it makes it look and feel like it's moving. So it's hard to do in such short time, but it'll at least give you an idea of like how my process goes. I usually don't paint as thick, but I really do like switching it up like this sometimes. It's fun. Sorry, Doc, but I've been crazy.
Go with him, Haley!
This is when I realize I have horrible posture. All my yoga teachers, shoulders back and down.
Sorry, check baby monitor.
Yes. So for the parents, Chels.
Mm-hmm.
It's like just what I needed, though.
A little bit of M.
What's up?
A little bit of M and M.
Yeah. I think I sold them all. Whoops. Having their happy accident down there. Mm. This is weird, I don't usually get to talk when I'm doing paintings.
Cool. I don't usually get to watch.
Yeah, well, true.
Beta's eye in the house.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
James Murphy.
Jim. Haven't seen you in too long, dude. Someone comes on next that determines if I can paint okay or not. Alright, let's see. Let's do some of this. Alright. Guys are seeing my inner thug right now. Baby, baby. their jars scenes.
Lisa Ryan would like to know, have you ever painted a wall mural from your favorite brother-in-law and his hot wife?
I have not painted a mural in a long time, and when I did, it was not something very cool. I would like to. I would love to, like, get some spray paint and tag up your walls.
Let's do it.
I'll get camouflage paint for Chris. What do you say, Chris?
Whoa, it's already 9:45.
8:45?
9:45.
Oh, okay. Wrap it up soon. Hope you guys don't mind the paint a smidge more. Let's see, some of this blue paint here. Oh, I also have to find some more spots for purple for Elle.
Yes.
Purple. Where's my purple? Purple, where are you? There we go.
Mommy?
Yes, love. There's no one in the show. Okay, come here.
What'd you say? Summer. Shouldn't be awake this late.
You say hi?
Hi.
Who do you want to see on the...
What do you want Daddy to paint?
A seagull.
Oh man, another request for a seagull.
A seagull? I like that request.
I like it too. It's just hard to do subtle stuff when you're in like a super hurry and like paint's all sloppy. She's like, I don't care, just do a seagull.
Yeah.
All right, purple is for Elle right here. Whoa, crazy camera effects over here with Chels. You have to let us back in your pool now, Elle. I'm earning my pool time here.
I get to wear the mermaid tail.
Yes. Okay, time for more blue. Let's see what else we got around here. What do we got over here? Cobalt blue. Looks fun. Worst days.
Check out the original palette. It's pretty cool.
Ooh, I like that color. It's fun. Let's see. I see that color over here. Sorry for the foul language music, guys, but I didn't write it. Biggie was pretty awesome. And for anyone watching, I like literally had no clue what I was painting when I started this video, so whether that's good or bad, I don't know. I'm just letting you know that, so. A little extra like pressure. More purple for Elle Tenhove. Oh, look at Chelsea with the big art words.
Cobalt.
It's like so cobalty.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. Do it again. Yeah, it kind of looks like it kind of like pops that color, right? Well, the yellow and purple are complementary colors, so you stick them next to each other, they pop.
We got comedians on here.
Oh, yeah?
Gabe Gomez says, quick fun fact about seagulls. Do you know why they are called seagulls? Because if they flew over the bay, they would be called bagels.
Boom.
Gabe
Gomez, drops the mic. Keep that fireman job, bro.
He said, I'm out. Good night.
Ah, come on, bro. We should be doing competing live Facebook feeds.
Yeah.
People could tune back and forth and hear your music. Gabe Gomez music. Check him out. Oh my god, I totally forgot to give Gabe a shout out before.
Yeah,
crap.
For the album cover.
Sorry, Gabe. Hope you didn't tune out yet. Gabe Gomez. Until I knew I forgot people and I wasn't even thinking. Sorry about that, dude.
Well, C-Zen in there. Forgot about it too. It's a good mix.
Yeah, iTunes has something going on. You can feel that cobalt. Chelsea likes the cobalt. Mm-hmm. 50 Cent in the house right now. Little fun fact, my friend Jay Cardiello, go check him out, is the personal trainer for Mr. 50 Cent.
A little studio scan. It's like...
It'd be funny if you like turned around and it was like 20 times more done.
Yeah, right.
But now, still in the same spot again.
It looks good.
How are you doing, camera woman?
Good.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The boys are asleep?
Mm-hmm. In their beds. A miracle.
Oh my god, incredible.
Hi, Sarisa.
Sarisa! What up, Grillo? Let's see, what color is that? Maybe some more different kinds of blues. I'm getting bored of these blues. Let's see. Uh-oh. Chelsea loves this color. not only that, but it's also cobalt.
What?
It's turquoise and it's cobalt. It's like a double, double cool thing. Messy. And this belongs right here. This is like really nice, nice color.
Leah wants to know where you make all your art. You mean like the painting, Leo, or like the canvases and stuff? Keep that now, that's one of my favorite colors too.
What is?
The turquoise.
Yeah, that's nice.
Like the original paintings. Here. She said, where do you make your original paintings?
Oh, pretty much right in this exact spot. This is not a mock-up TV studio. It's actually my art studio, guys. Goopy paint.
You're so you say you can show everything. It's all his thousands of paintbrushes.
Color is cool, so squirt more of it out here. Let's see here.
She's got like ripples and then light, just different reflections. Masking.
You're asking what? I'm sorry, I was just zoning out. What'd you say?
Is it like reflections that you focus on, or is it like ripples, or how do you see it?
I don't label it like that. I kind of just look at it and like, I try to like sense where it's telling me to put the color, like where I would, like if I pick up a color, I'm like, where do you belong? And it kind of like tells me like, oh, I'm right here. And it's kind of like a combination of form of like the ripple combined with color and like, you know, ambient colors and shadows and tones. It's like all, it all happens at the same time. Like it's a big conversation that's going on. It's kind of like being in like a subway and everyone's talking and you kind of zone into different parts. But if you wanted to jump into one of the conversations, you can do so. It's kind of like that. If that makes any sense.
Yeah, it's cool way to explain it. Intuitive painting, Kate Kat Ellison.
Yeah. If you think about it too much, that's kind of when you screw up. I think like that question about style before, it's just kind of like if you just stop thinking so damn hard and just try to speak with the paint and try to let the paint speak to you, it like it'll form its own conversation, and that's when like all the cool stuff happens. And it doesn't always happen, like maybe only a fraction of the time you're painting it's actually like something really super magical feeling, but that feeling you sort of chase down and you try to keep chasing it and chasing it until you catch it, and then it runs away again and it just happens.
Do you think anyone can get there to an intuitive painting state, or do you think you're just born with it and that's it?
I think anyone can get to that state. I don't know if it's necessarily painting for everyone, but I think the state is more important than what you do during or through that state. I think anyone could get better at painting for sure. Well, first of all, in today's society, it's so subjective. Like, you can pretty much see anything in an art gallery if it's on a wall, so I think anyone could be a painter, but I think tapping into that space is more important than what you do with it. What do you think, Chels?
That's my question.
Well, I'm asking you. That's my question.
I agree. I think you can tap into it in many different ways. You just find what your painting is, whether it's music or yoga or...
Yeah. How's she doing over there?
She's almost asleep.
Yeah. Since we're winding down, I'm just going to start throwing in some little details here and there. Like, I don't want to call it the final touches, but that's kind of what it is. But kind of.
I think our whole neighborhood's on here. Hey, Mike.
Hey, Mike. Mr. Conti.
Kate said that's also like the shamanic journeying too. Ask a question and the answer comes as you are guided. I love that, Kate.
Yeah, totally. That's totally it. You also have to be, like, I think, brave enough to push through, because it's not really the most safe or comfortable space to push through, no matter what medium you're using, whether it is yoga or meditation or childbirth for that matter or anything. Like, you have to be willing or not have a choice to push through, and that's not always easy, and it may come easier to me in some ways, and in other ways I feel paralyzed by it. That's just kind of the part of the process. So one of the things I like about painting most is that it forces me to take those lessons back to other parts of my life.
Mommy?
Yeah.
Not so much for being asleep.
You have to see this.
What is it?
It's going to be rad.
Wow.
It's a monster.
Wow. Someone, do you like Daddy's painting?
You have to see this.
Okay.
Look at
it. Let me see. Whoa.
Summer, what do you think of the painting?
Do you want to try? Do you want to paint? Oh, it's a Ninja Turtle. Cool.
What's that?
I see.
Am I looking at that monster?
Whoa.
See, that's Raph.
I see.
Raph is a monster.
I see, sweetie.
Raph is a monster.
I see. Do you want to say hi to everyone?
Hi, everyone.
What are you watching?
I'm watching Ninja Turtle.
Yes.
It's your favorite.
Summer Leo says hi.
What happened to Outcast? Anyone know? Summer, what happened to Outcast? Whatever happened to that?
A rabbit is a monster.
Oh my gosh, are you kidding me?
Chaos and Elder Sound.
Yes, I think I threw some weights in here.
Hi, Ed. You missed the Echo Movement shout out.
Ed? Ed? You're here hanging out with me, Ed. You should have brought your drums and like your... We gotta get Ed here with his music.
Yes.
And baby Franny.
Yes.
My friend, my wife is banana in here.
Same for you. Okay, so Brian Rorman says, this is awesome. It almost looks like schools of fish making up the bottom portion of the wave.
See, look at that. You're seeing like an artist already.
I like it, Brian. That's cool.
That's cool.
Uncle Chris says, what?
Epic.
What?
Now it's like stuck in my head. Yeah. It's all my kids say all day. Uncle Chris say what? Probably like the most important part.
All right, guys, we're gonna close up. Any other questions before we are almost finished?
Some final touches. This is like where the magic happens or something.
Mommy, I have a show with my favorite though.
Okay.
It's okay, honey, you can talk. Using the mural paint now. What's up, mural paint?
Oh, yeah, now I see.
It's like really flowy, yeah. Can't do that with the other paint.
What was your most memorable painting from Laura Lee?
Oh man, most memorable painting. That is so hard to answer. So I would have to just go with... my daughter wants to answer.
My
Summer.
What, baby girl?
This one's my favorite.
Oh, that's a good show.
Yeah, it's an ant show.
An ant show?
Yeah.
It doesn't look very educational.
It's good.
Okay. The most memorable painting. I don't even know how to answer that because like every painting is like your most memorable, right? Like as you're experiencing it, I try my best, not always successfully by any stretch of the imagination, but I try to be present when I'm painting them all, so they all feel like really connected with me. The first one that popped in my head, which doesn't mean it's like the answer or not, was like probably Rio Jam was one of the ones that kind of popped in my head just because of like the story behind it and the experience that inspired the piece. That was like one of them, but they really all have like stories that are probably just as special to me, so it's hard to answer that, I guess. It's like asking what your favorite kid is, like you can't do that, like, not because you don't want to, there's no such thing, you know. It's like asking if french fries or pizza are better to most people, right? Like,
thanks, that was fun watching and learning about your process. Looks so beautiful and mystical as waves are. Kate Catanella.
Thank you. I had fun sharing this with you guys. I wish I had more time to finish. I'm gonna probably spend a little bit, another 5 minutes or so if Chelsea's arm is not gonna fall off. Just because it's like super hard to actually stop. Sometimes takes this long just to kind of get a flow and like figure out what it is I'm gonna do. And I finally feel like, okay, now I'm getting a flow for it a little bit.
So love your work. So glad you're doing live feeds. I finally get to see you in action. Cheers and thank you.
Thank you. Who was nice enough to say that?
I'm gonna butcher this. I'm sorry. Jelani.
Thank you very much. Jeff, you said?
Jelani.
Sorry about that. Jelani. That's a cool name.
Really cool. I'm probably butchering it. I'm sorry.
Thank you very much for the nice comment.
We're going to try to do these often. So.
Mommy, look!
Cool. Probably with not so many kids next.
Yeah, if they sleep well for us, that is.
Yeah.
So I think what it needs right now before we wrap up is I need to kind of have some light popping through the wave to make it appear more... Okay, nice music,
song.
Sorry. Nice little comical overtone to my process. What inspires you? Really raunchy gangster rap.
So Ed actually just asked, so Ed, we did answer that before, but there's a lot of new people on. What kind of, what is your favorite type of music to listen to while painting?
So yeah, I'll answer it again, maybe in a different variant. So it really depends on my mood, and I listen to everything, literally. I listen to mostly an iTunes radio or a Pandora type scenario, and I just let it kind of flow. So as if, for instance, when I was painting some of the slightly stupid pieces recently, I was listening to their music to kind of get in the flow, and a lot of times I listen to Jack Johnson or G-Love or Donovan or ALO or Citizen Cope, that kind of vibe, and then sometimes I'll switch it up and listen to just a bunch of gangster rap, and I love jazz, and I love classical, and sometimes I listen to opera, and I love pretty much everything. And sometimes, I was saying before, I just listen to hours and hours of audiobooks. It depends on what I'm doing with the painting. If I'm doing something with the painting that doesn't require a certain portion of my brain, I keep my brain busy with an audiobook, because my busy mind is busy listening, while the other part of my more fluid, creative side has an ability to kind of express, so they're both kind of kept happy. And so I listen to everything, and I think it's important to do that.
Thanks, Ed. Jeremy says, thanks for showing us your process. Looks amazing. Love to your fam from Erica and myself. See you soon.
Love you guys. Stay out of the hospital, Jeremy.
Yeah. We have Gorgeous from Carrie. Thank you for bringing us into your studio. I show my art students your work all the time. We are huge fans.
Awesome.
Awesome for the kids to see a local artist really killing it out there. It really helps them believe that they can be successful when they see your work. That's Ashley Golick again. Thanks, Ashley.
Thank you, Ashley. For all you teachers out there, I would love to be able to go into your school and speak to the kids. I did that last year a couple times to my old high school, Howell High School, Go Rebels, and Old Bridge High School. I went into and talked to the teachers, and I talked to the art students, and I really love doing that. So if I could ever help anyone with that is in driving distance, let me know.
Our phone flies there, that's fine too.
Or yeah, if you want to fly me to Costa Rica or Hawaii, I would love to talk to you guys. Alright, probably should stop. Gotta get my daughter to sleep. I don't want to stop, but I have to. It means I have to sign it. Unless I decide to go back tomorrow and keep painting, but for now at least it'll be done. And then if I wake up and say, I want to keep going, then I'll maybe keep going. We'll see. But if you're going to watch, you have to at least watch it being sort of done-ish. All right. Thank you guys very much for joining me. I appreciate it. And again, please check out my website, go to my newsletter, buy art so I can buy my kids food. And
keep in touch, because we'll do this again soon.
Peace, guys. Thank you.
Have a good one.